drug agents say they've kicked the door in on some major marijuana dealers in Central Florida. Literally, more than a dozen homes searched, multiple arrests, and hundreds of pounds of high-priced marijuana off the streets. WESH 2's Dave McDaniel has been working with his sources for weeks. He broke the news of this bust before dawn this morning, and you are back with us live now with the latest, Dave.
Well, that's right. You know, agents tell me that this group was selling anywhere from $500,000 to $750,000 worth of pot per week. And they say that a lot of that pot was being sold on the UCF and the Florida State campuses. Many in that group got a rude wake-up call this morning. A total of 14 search warrants in five counties, all served at 6 in the morning. The idea is to make sure people are home and make sure no one can phone a friend. Police had already intercepted some marijuana, even seized a few guns, but this was about stopping the group, not slowing it down. One after another, people were arrested. Some quiet, some with a strong opinion about current laws.
I do believe that California has it legalized, and hopefully soon the whole nation will have it legalized.
For now, it's not. Cole and three other principal players, according to drug agents, just some of the ones arrested. And any cars used to haul marijuana, taken away by the drug agents.
I have to tell you, in 30 years, I don't know of one case I've been associated with where we have had more evidence against an organization than we have in this case.
The City County Investigative Bureau, by mid-afternoon, had seized 17 guns, 600 pounds of pot, and nearly $250,000 in cash. But they say the evidence is more than that. They claim to have audio, video, and eyes on their main suspects, backing up their claim that these men were selling dope by the plane load. That's right. The agents say some marijuana was delivered here from California by a pilot on the payroll. And the agents told me late this afternoon that they realize that a lot of members of the public don't get all that worked up over a marijuana arrest, but they point out that in this particular case, they know of several home invasions tied to this group. In one, they say 15 shots were fired, but thankfully nobody was hit. They say it's as much as stopping the pot as it is stopping the violence. Reporting live in Seminole County, Dave McDaniel, WESH 2 News.